What it do, YouTube? It is that time of week again. I know everybody's still trying to settle in after that Miami Miracle last weekend against the New England Patriots, but it's time to dial back in. It's time to dial back in, and let's get down to the nitty-gritty, man. First off, I like to say, hey, the Miami Dolphins still have an opportunity to sit back and win the division. If we just sit back and win out, and just hopefully the New England Patriots end up losing against the Pittsburgh Steelers or end up losing to either the Buffalo Bills or the New York Jets, it's a possibility that the Miami Dolphins may be the AFC East champs for the year of 2018. The first time since, I can't even think off the top of my head the last time the Miami Dolphins ended up being the AFC East champs. But one little stat I wanted to sit back and key on was Kirk Cousins. Kirk Cousins, he is 4-19 against 500 teams, which means teams with winning records. He cannot win against winning teams. So that ends up going into our favor. Let's go ahead and get into the preview. So defensively, over this past week, I've been hearing a lot of criticism about Mack Burke's play calling. But to be honest with you, I was complaining during the game, but as I rewatched the game against the New England Patriots, I cannot complain about how Mack Burke called the game. He basically single covered almost everybody on the field. He didn't single out one receiver, which reason why Gronk was ended up being open so many times. But it did not give another wide receiver an opportunity. And plus, two things I like to point out. Is the fact that, how many rushing yards we gave up? Gave up less than 100 yards rushing. So, if we can establish that type of dominance, we prevent a team from running the ball on us, we can make it extremely difficult. They play right into our hands. But as far as the Minnesota Vikings go, like I said, we have to continue success with our run D. If we could do that, we could force the Minnesota Vikings to end up passing the ball. And if we end up forcing the Minnesota Vikings to pass the ball, we can put pressure on the quarterback, which last week we put a lot of pressure on Tom Brady. Didn't exactly get to him for the sack, but really, sacks aren't important, like I said to you before, but as long as you're getting to the quarterback, it's making that presence known that you're getting there. So if we can constantly keep putting pressure on Kirk Cousins is prone to turn the ball over. He is prone to turn the ball over. So if we can force a couple turnovers and set up our offense with a short field because their Minnesota Vikings defense is that good, then I think we could punch it in on a short field as far as our offense. Now, I would also like to highlight the fact that Xavier Howard, he didn't exactly practice. I'm not expecting him to play for the second straight week. So Torrey McTyre, Bobby McCain, Minkah Fitzpatrick, y'all going to have to step up big time because the Minnesota Vikings, literally, they have two bad boy receivers on the outside with Adam Thielen and Stephon Diggs. So let's go ahead and move on to the offensive. One of the things I'll set back and keep underlining is the offensive line execution. I felt like the offensive line did a fairly good job last week of protecting Ryan Tannehill, but it wasn't exactly flawless. So let's go ahead and continue the success of protecting Ryan Tannehill and also holding up blocks in the run game. It's always that one block that can just blow up a whole runner play. So it's key. It is key to sit back and actually have perfect execution as far as an offensive line in the running game. Now, we found ourselves a new weapon on the ground last week against the New England Patriots, Brandon Bolden. Literally, I didn't know he had the potential to sit back and break out something like that. I hope it's not a fluke, but let's go ahead and try to get him involved along with Frank Gore and Kenyon Drake. And also, let's go ahead and get Kenyon Drake involved, lining him up as a receiver, like line him up all over the place, because like I said, we have a serious amount of success when we end up lining Kenyon Drake up in different positions. Also, set up the play action pass. I think Tannehill thrives in that play action pass, and it's like I said, it's imperative for us to sit back and run the ball. Also, considering the fact that Tannehill is a little banged up, we try to keep the Minnesota Vikings' paws off of him as much as possible. But final score, I'm going to go ahead and go 24-17 Miami. End up taking it over the Minnesota Vikings, making us 8-6. I have a strong feeling this is going to be our year to sit back and take the AFC East. I feel it. I literally feel it. But let me know what you guys think. You know what it is. If you enjoy the content, please don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. This is Great with DeVore. I'm up out of here.